Hi, welcome back. We are at chapter 4, or in textbook is chapter 15. Yeah, kinetics of particle. We are looking at impulse and momentum. Yeah, you may refer to page 237 of the textbook. Okay, so today's objective would be to calculate the linear momentum of a particle and linear impulse of the force and apply the principle of linear impulse and momentum. Application. It has got a lot of applications. It mostly involved with accidents or something to do with impact. Yeah. So example for this is like a dent in a trailer fender can be removed using an impulse tool, which delivers a force over a very short time interval. To do so, the weight is gripped and jerked upward, striking on the stopping ring. So this device also uses impact, yeah. And then a good example of impulse is the action of hitting the ball with a bat. Okay, the impulse is the average force exerted by the bat multiplied by the time of the bat in contact. So these are the questions, like, is the impulse a vector? So these are the things that we are going to solve, we're going to study, and we're going to solve in this chapter. So another example, when a stick is struck by a sledgehammer, a large impulse of force is delivered to the stick, drives it into the ground. So it's mostly involving something of like collision or some impact, knocking, all those things comes under this topic. Okay, so principle of linear and impulse momentum. Next method we will consider for solving particle kinetics, obtaining by integrating the equation of motion with respect of time. Yeah, so that is the thing, integration of equation of motion. The results is referred to as principle of impulse and momentum. It can be applied to problems involving both linear and angular motion. The principle is useful for solving that involve force, velocity and time. It can be also used to analyze the mechanics of impulse, which comes in the impact topic. Yeah? Now, angular motion, that is for your self-study. Yeah. You can just study by yourself, yeah. Okay, now let's look at this principle of linear impulse and momentum. Okay, it's obtained by integrating this equation. So finally, this is the when you integrate this equation, you will end up with mv2 minus mv1. I think this formula you have seen in your physics class, yeah, or your secondary school itself. Yeah, it's a famous formula. Okay, so now linear momentum is given by L. It's the same direction with V. So of course this is actually a vector, yeah, it's a vector. So direction is very, very important, yeah. So linear impulse is an integral of f dt, and the linear impulse is denoted by I. So we have I, it is a vector quantity measuring the effect of the force during its time interval of action. I acts in the same direction as f, and it is unit of Newton second. Do not worry about your English unit, that's not important at all. We only look at SI. Okay, so the impulse may be determined by direct integration, like here. The area under the FT graph would be the impulse. Yeah, can be represented. Okay, that's done. So I is also equivalent to force times with time. Yeah, so this is the integration part. You don't have to know the integration. What you need to know is how to use the final formula. Okay, I repeat, you just need to understand how to integrate, but you need not, that's not being tested in our syllabus. Most of it is that you have to use this formula. Yeah, so mv1 plus fdt equals to mv. Okay, remember the f that we calculated from the previous lessons. So those f's are actually very useful for this component here. Okay, so the particle initial momentum plus with a sum, yeah, with a sum is equivalent to the final momentum. Yeah, so it's very important that you draw the momentum diagram to indicate the direction, because this is a vector. Very, very important, because whether if the direction taken this side is positive, so if it's an opposite, then it will be negative. It will impact on the value, so it's very important. Now, as we are approaching higher level of engineering level, yeah, so we'll be looking at 3D, yeah, x, y, and z. The same formula, but it is in different axis. We do not mix up the x with the y, and with y with the z. They are independent of each other. Yeah, okay. Now, problem solving. The most important is to define the coordinate system. That is really very important because we have x-axis to be solved in x and y-axis to be solved in y. You don't mix it up. Yeah, okay. So we draw a free, so first thing is to draw a free body particle. I think I've been telling this from the previous chapters many times. Free body diagram is actually important. So you need to also establish the direction of the object, and you may also need to draw the impulse and momentum diagram. Yeah, I'll show all that. Then you resolve the forces and the velocity based on the coordinate, and then you put in the formula inside and you solve the question. I'm going to show you some example here. As usual, I'll be skipping the textbook example because they are rather easy. But before that, let me just go into principle of linear impulse and momentum and conservation of linear momentum for system. It's just the same thing, but it's just talking about the conservation. Yeah, it's the same formula. Yeah, at the end of the day, you need to apply the principle of linear impulse and momentum to the symptom particle. Yeah. So you remember the formula that I explained just now? Yeah, this one, summation of mv, so we call that I initial plus with summation of fdt. Just now we were just talking about single object, so now it is actually combination of object plus vi case 2 final. Okay, what is I is that the ith object, so it can be object A, object B, object C, yeah, anything, yeah. But it will be solved by, if x-axis, it's by x-axis, if y-axis, by y-axis, yeah, okay. So once again, the application, there are many applications, as what I've explained to you. It's more of like impacts, yeah. You can just read up on it, okay. This is what I was just telling just now. Okay, we only look at external forces because we assume that the internal forces will cancel off by itself among each other. So we only look at the external forces. Like what I've explained to you, I can be object A. Okay, wait a minute. Okay, this one will be only one object. Sorry, yeah, this is not ABC, this is only A, but it's all in one axis. X means X, Y means Y. Okay, I will just clarify it shortly with this example, then you will understand. So let's go to the example. Okay, just to make you understand. So let's look at this question. Yeah, so what we have here, 100 kilogram crate originally at rest and smooth horizontal surface. Okay, if a towing force of 200 acting at the angle of 45, so you have a towing force 200 acting at 45, so it's not a straight line. Yeah, it has to be resolved. It can be resolved into x-axis and y-axis, just take note of that. It's applied for 10 seconds. Time is very important for calculation of momentum. Yeah, determine the final velocity, normal force which the surface exits on the crate at the time interval. Now this question can be also solved similar manner with all the chapter 14, but the thing is, since that we are in impulse, we use this impulse topic to solve this question. Okay, once again I repeat, this question can be solved based on chapter 14 itself, but we do not want that. We, since that we are in chapter 15, we will solve it with the impulse method. Yeah, okay, let's look at this. The first step is to define the x and y axis. So in this case you only have x and y axis, so don't worry about z axis. Yeah, okay. The next step is actually to draw the free body diagram. Can you see? This is the free body diagram which shows the forces, and this is the diagram which shows the movement, the kinetics. It's important, yeah. These two diagrams is very, very important because you need to draw it to define it, yeah, to define the movement. Otherwise, it's very difficult. Okay. Now you solve by axis. So first thing is to solve by x-axis. So you write the formula that we have discussed just now, m. This object, only one object, so in this case there's only one object, so fdt and mv. So initially the crate is at rest, so which means the initial velocity is zero. And then what are the forces, what are the forces that's in x direction? So we don't take this is in y direction, The only force that's in x direction is actually 200 cos 45. Multiply with the time equals to 100 multiplied with velocity. Why do you take the velocity? Because at the end of the day, the box is actually moving in x-axis. So now you see that drawing the diagram is actually very important to define all the movement so that it's easier for you when you fit into the formula. Yeah. Okay, then you can solve for your final velocity. Now we use the similar formula now, yeah, but the thing now we solve for the y-axis. So in y-axis we have my, there's no movement in y-axis, so look at this, there's no movement in y-axis, so it is zero. But we have forces, we have nc, we have 981, so nc times 10, yeah, n is force really, yeah, so don't worry, force times 10. And then you see the weight is actually 100, 100 times 9.81, only then you get force, yeah. This formula is force times time, yeah. Then we have the 200 sine 45 times with 10, and there's no movement in y-axis. Look at this again, there's no movement in y-axis. So what we have? We have zero, okay. So can you understand now? So we have zero, we have zero here. So you can solve for the NC. Okay, so if you to draw this diagram, if you see, this is your M, the first part of the formula. Okay, the first part of the formula, which is the MV, initial, I always call it 1. Okay, this will be the force, all the forces. Okay, all the forces. This will be the final velocity. You get it, you know? Yeah, so this diagram, can you see this diagram actually represents the formula. Okay, now in your exam you don't need to draw this diagram, no need. The only diagram that you need to draw is actually this and this. They carry marks, yeah, these two diagram carries marks. Okay, so now we have come to the end of this chapter, the first component of not this chapter here, just 15.1 and 15.2 of the textbook. So I'll meet you again in the next video, yeah, for 15.3. Okay.